Why do I feel like this?
So tell me, how's it feel?
But this, it's worth it.
L'amour est comme l'oiseau de Twitter. On est bleu de lui seulement pour 48 heures. D'abord on s'affilie, ensuite on se follow. On en devient fêlé et on finit solo.
Prends garde à toi.
You see it? It's right there. Hold your horses, Clem. Sorry. There's something in the treehouse, and she wants me to get a video of it to show you guys. Look, by the door. It's peeking out. I think it's... Yep, got it. Oh, there. Look at that. There it is. Do you see it? Spoiler, it's a raccoon. Yeah. Oh, no, no, no. Here, your mom wants to talk to you. Hi, Mom.
Hi, hon. What's in your treehouse?
Baby raccoon.
Wow, that's cool.
Yep.
I bet he's cute.
Uh-huh.
Well, make sure you don't try and touch him, okay?
Okay, gotta go. Talk to you later. Hey, that's not any way to say bye to your mother.
Honey, you still there?
Yep. I'm here, Mom.
Hey, don't get my hat dirty. I said you could borrow it, not have it.
Okay.
You be nice to Sandra.
And don't stay up too late.
I won't.
We love you, Clem.
Love you, hon.
I love you, too. I miss you.
Don't worry, sweetie. We'll be home in a few days.
Okay, see you soon.
When the dead started walking, I was small and alone. Until a man named Lee became my protector. He protected me as long as he could, taught me how to survive, how to shoot a gun, lots of stuff. How to say goodbye. I remember right after the walkers showed up. We lived in a motor inn, survived really awful shit. Everyone was convinced it'd be over in a few weeks. An age without walkers, like it used to be. But like everything else, it wouldn't last. I met another group after that. There was a woman who gave birth to a boy named Alvin Jr. My friend Kenny started to take care of him. I thought we'd found something that worked, but I was wrong again, and I didn't get to say goodbye. Everybody dies. It's not really up to us anymore. It never really gets easier. AJ and I had been searching for a long time for some place we could call home, never knowing when we'd find any supplies. I didn't know how bad it would be. Everything looks the same out there. It's hard to trust people sometimes. No need to explain. Believe me, there's a reason. While searching for a place to call home, AJ and I found an old boarding school run by kids deep in the forest. Their leader was a guy named Marlin. It felt like a chance at having a home. A real one. I've made a lot of friends here. Well, more or less. We had to go back to the train station to see if any food survived the explosion. Just when we thought we'd found a huge stash of food, it turned out to be a trap. Someone else had the same idea. When AJ distracted him, I shoved him into a pack of walkers. But you can survive a bite if you cut it off fast enough. I found Marlin and Brody in the basement that night. Arguing about the man we'd seen, and I learned why Brody was so afraid. The man was part of a group of raiders they'd run into a year ago. Marlin traded Tennessee's older sisters to the raiders to keep himself safe. He attacked Brody and locked me in the basement with her. Marlin stole AJ's gun and tried to convince them I had murdered Brody. Lewis backed me up. I attacked Marlin and made him drop the gun. I told him he could stay, but he couldn't be our leader. But Marlin was dead. AJ killed him, and I didn't stop it. I told AJ that what he'd done was murder, that he'd have to atone for it. Sometimes people do bad things, like Marlin did. And as bad as Marlin was, he still saved me and AJ. The other kids agreed. They still voted to kick us out. AJ and I were attacked by Abel, one of the raiders Marlin had given the twins to. He was with someone I thought I'd never see again. Lily. Lily and I were friends right at the start. It feels like forever ago. After I told them how we could defend the school against the raiders, they were willing to let us stay. They busted open our gates, but the kids stayed hidden as planned, until Ten ran out of cover, hoping for a chance to learn about his missing sisters. The bomb went off, and attempting to save Ten, Mitch threw himself at Lily and got a knife to the throat. With only a second to decide, I fired and saved Lewis. They got away with three of our friends. I'll make these bastards pay for this. I promise. Could have been the end. Just when I gave up hope, AJ decided to make the call. And without him, I'd be dead. But only for a minute. It's good to feel safe somewhere. Friends. Good ones. Even more than a friend. One last time. Thank you. For everything.
Tengo un medic, Coco Fendi, tengo el Brody en el trap. Show de 20s, gasto ferry, Prada para traquetear, gasto ferry.